Good evening. I'm Piers Morgan, or as you know me, the British Mario Lopez. This week, a series of shocking and confusing revelations. Who lied about what? Who is still hiding the truth? And who? What? Huh? Who? Joining me first is a man I consider to be the most despicable, vile human being ever to set foot on planet Earth, and I'm so happy to have him. Lance Armstrong.
Hello there, Paris. I'm excited to be here tonight to apologize to all the viewers out there, you know, who couldn't find the OWN network on their televisions.
Lance, in your interview with Oprah, you did admit to using drugs, but a lot of people said that you showed no remorse whatsoever.
Who said that? Who? They're liars, those fat bitches!
Lance.
No, I'm sorry, totally sorry. That was my fault. I accept full responsibility, even though you did provoke me, you know, so the blame is probably 70-30 on you, you know. Also, I think a lot of the reason I just yelled was because of the cancer I had, which is not an excuse, you know, I mean, unless you think it is. But the most important thing is I never, ever called anyone a fat bitch.
Now, Lance, your confession also lacked any real details. Would you care to elaborate on your sophisticated system of doping?
It wasn't really all that sophisticated, Piers. All I actually did was steroids, testosterone, human growth hormone, EPO, and I replaced all of my blood with better blood. You know, so, I mean, is that sophisticated? You know, I don't know. Is it cheating? Maybe. You know, am I sorry I did it? Yes, ish. P.S. No.
Also joining us tonight via satellite is a man on the other end of a vicious lie. Please welcome Notre Dame linebacker, Manti Te'o.
Hey, Piers!
Now, Mr. Te'o, your story is one of the most perplexing in all of sports. You claim to have a girlfriend named Linnae, and that she died of leukemia.
Yeah.
But it turns out that she never existed. How do you explain that?
Well, Piers, the sad fact is I was the victim of a cruel and senseless hoax.
That must be devastating to deal with.
It is, but it's even more devastating for my girlfriend, Linnae.
Wait, no, see, Linnae was the hoax. She's not a real person.
Oh! Right, now I get it. Oh, man, Linnae is gonna be pissed.
Teo, talk us through the moment when you found out your girlfriend was dead.
Well, a couple months ago, she called me up on the phone and she was like, "Hey, I have bad news, I'm dead." And I said, "Oh no! Do you need a ride to the funeral?" But she said, "No, it's okay. My body is being shot out into outer space, so you don't need to show up or ask any questions about it, huh?"
That seems very hard to believe.
Yeah, that's what I told Linnae.
All right, let's step away from him. And finally, joining us from Los Angeles is an actress who made a surprising half-revelation at the Golden Globes, Jodie Foster.
I'm 50. I can stretch and kick and stretch, and I'm 50.
I didn't ask, but that's great. So, Jodie, while many found your Golden Globe speech to be beautiful, others were confused by the message.
Okay, Pierce, look, here's the deal, sir. I am not Honey Boo Boo. I don't have my own fragrance line. I don't have a speech writer. I don't have a publicist to look over what I say. I don't have a delete key on my computer. All I had at the Golden Globes were my notes. That's them. And the support of my two most trusted advisors, the voices of reason in my life, Robert Downey Jr. and Mel Gibson. Woo!
Woo! But Jodie, it sounded like you were trying to make an announcement of sorts. Would you care to elaborate on that?
Yes, I would, sir. Allow me to set the record straight once and for all. I'm just gonna put it out there, loud, proud, right? Here we go. I am game for anything. I'm just totally game for anything. Also, I am officially a Leslie Nielsen fan. I just thought you all should know that. Oh, and I am obsessed with Girls, the show. I just love that show. So, whoo! It's all finally out there. That is such a giant weight off of my lesbian chest.
All right. Let's take a break. When we return, we'll have a hard-hitting debate on gun control with who else? Liam from One Direction. Oh, and live from New York, it's Saturday Night!